Welcome to the VRF Wizard. We are going to discuss VRF Piping Design Software. In the description below, we'll leave a link to each of the VRF manufacturer's software program. VRF manufacturers require that you use their proprietary software to design the refrigeration piping for the installation of their VRF systems. You or your engineer will need to have a cooling and heating load to import or use with the VRF piping design software. So you got to know the loads of each room. Using energy modeling software is great for heat recovery systems. The heat recovery system allows you simultaneously heating and cooling. That optimizes zoning layout. Below, I will have a link for each of the manufacturers' VRF piping design software, at least those that we can find. Some of them are difficult to find. The VRF piping diagram. The VRF manufacturer software will provide a schematic piping diagram showing all the outdoor and indoor units along with any accessories. Now, on most of the softwares, you'll have to choose the indoor unit, and the software program will pick the appropriate outdoor units, or it'll give you options to pick various outdoor units. The piping diagram will also show pipe sizes and lengths that were used in the calculations. Of course, you will be asked to enter the lengths of the piping unless your VRF sales representative has agreed to do it for you based on already a design set of plans and specs. But someone will have to enter the lengths of pipes, and then the software will automatically indicate whether the design has exceeded the allowable lengths as dictated by the VRF manufacturer. You can see in this diagram here that the VRF design software will give you the following. You know, it'll give you the indoor model numbers. It will give you the thermostat or controller model number. It will tell you the size of the pipe. And of course, you put the length in, but it'll tell you what size you'll need. It'll pick the selector box, and this is for a heat recovery system. If you just got a heat pump, then you won't have these. And it'll give you the size of the pipe going to the outdoor units. And once you've selected all your indoor units, it will select the outdoor unit or give you an option from various outdoor units. Now you'll have a VRF wiring diagram that will be automatically calculated for you or shown for you. It's telling you you need 22.7 amps. It'll be three phase. The next, it will tell you the power required to the branch selector box and the amps. Next, it will show you the same for the indoor units. Here's 1 amp, single phase. It'll add them all up, tell you your total load. 5 amp single phase in this example. And then the control wiring, as you can see, it'll show your control wiring goes from your controller in the room to the indoor unit. You can group indoor units onto one controller if they have the same zone, the same requirements. And then from the indoor unit, you will daisy chain them together. That's how the control system works. You don't have to run home runs from each one of them. You daisy chain them together, and then from there you'll take a control wire to your branch selector box, or whatever the particular VRF manufacturer calls their box. This is the box that determines whether you're going to get heating or cooling. And then from that branch selector box, that will also be daisy changed from one box to the other. And then from there, it'll go out to the outdoor unit and connect to the unit. And then the outdoor units will be daisy chained together. And then from there to your main controller. The bill of materials. The VRF piping design software will provide a bill of materials for the project, which should include a minimum of the equipment model numbers and capacity, accessories like your branch selector boxes, Y branches, headers, pipe sizes and lengths, the controls required, thermostats, and then the factory refrigerant charge and additional refrigerant charge required for all the lengths of your pipe. The VRF software could also provide or generate an equipment schedule to be used on your CAD design drawings. VRF system sizing diversity factor. This is known by various names that each VRF manufacturer uses to describe the ratio of the indoor unit capacity to the outdoor unit capacity. The first involves the total peak load of all the indoor units divided by the total capacity of the outdoor units that they're connected to. So you got total indoor capacity, peak capacity, divided by your outdoor unit capacity. That'll give you a diversity ratio. Cooling load diversities occur when the engineer provides zoning of the indoor units with different peak load times. So not all your internal or your loads or your zones are going to peak at the same time. Your west exposure, your south, your east, your north, your internal zones, they're all going to have different peaks. So there's some diversity built already into the system based on the different times the zones will peak. Below, I have put a link to some of the VRF, VRV manufacturers' software programs that you can download or request. Right now, quickly, I'll show you how to find Daikin's, Mitsubishi's, and Samsung software. The rest will be in the link below. Okay, this is the Daikin website where you'll get their VRV piping design software. You might want to select the country if you're not in the U.S. You just scroll down and it says here for professionals. You can see off to the left here, here's the VRV Web Xpress. That's their piping design software for the VRV system. Here's a video that explains what the software capabilities are. And here is contact your local Daikin representative. That's the only way in order to get the software from them. You can see here that this will take you through selecting the units, outdoor units, all the indoor units. You just pick and drop them. Set all the parameters, then it'll start to design it. You tell it the linear feet of pipe. It'll tell you if you got any errors. And then it'll start to give you the layout and the sizing. Tell you if there's anything that's piping lengths are too long. So it's easy to use. You'll just have to contact your rep in order to get a copy. Just follow the link below to the Mitsubishi site. You can see here, this is for their Diamond System Builder, which is what they call their VRF design software. Scroll down once again. This will tell you its capabilities, built-in testing to make sure all the lengths and all the parameters fit within their design specs. It'll generate schematics. It'll give you a summary sheet. Just keep scrolling down. And if you want to request a training and have a request form, and then here's the software download. Unfortunately, for those who use Apple, it's only available for the Windows version. Here's Samsung's website where you can get the software, the DVM Pro System Design Software. Just scroll down. They have two modes. They have the CAD mode or the sales mode. Most likely, if you're not a CAD designer, you'll pick the sales mode. Go down a little further, and this is where you can download the software. If you like our video, please hit the subscribe button and the bell so that you get notified when our next video is released.